Hi, in this video we are going to set up the software necessary for Opal port. We assume that we have a Raspberry Pi with SSH enabled. You installed already the Raspberry OS and it is accessible via the Wi-Fi. We connect to the Raspberry Pi using the SSH command. The password is Raspberry, username is Pi. As we can see, we successfully logged and we just check the home folder here. It is home@pi. Now we are going to config the Raspberry port. We need to enable some features. For sure SSH, we need to enable it. It is already enabled, so we don't need actually to do this using through the SSH. But anyway, it is a step. We need to enable SPI, which is a hardware interface. We need to enable I2C, is another way to interface with the sensors. And we need to enable serial port. We don't want the shell, but we need the serial port itself to be enabled. So we select no, then we select yes. Okay. Now we need to restart the board to apply the settings. Again, we enter to the board. Here we are going to go to a file called config in the boot. This file contains a lot of configurations. We will enter using the nano command to edit it. Our concern here is the I2C speed. The default I2C speed is 100 kilohertz, but in ArduPilot we need to raise this speed to 400 kilohertz in order to access different sensors in a high speed. Here we added the command to raise the speed, and that's it. Now we are going to my desktop to download the ArduPilot. I downloaded already ArduPilot using Git. I just update the repository. I will check out the master and I will update the submodules. I will remove the folders under the module folder, not the module folder itself, the subfolders under it. Then I will execute a git submodule update to update the folder. Now we are ready to compile the Opal code. The Opal code is compiled on my desktop using cross-compile. As we can see, it compiles a lot of files and it can take a while on your desktop. Here we have the file. Now we are going to copy this file to the Raspberry board. Here I use the Raspberry Zero, so this file, as we will see later, it will not work and I will explain why. Now I will copy the file to Raspberry, the home location of the user Pi. Okay, file is copied. Now I'm going to enter to the Raspberry board using SSH. Here it is, the file. Before executing the file, we need to create a param file. The param file here contains the initial settings. The initial settings we need to enter here is the type of quadcopter. We need to define that it is a quadcopter and it is X configuration. Sure, you can define any other type. You can add also extra parameters, but this is the mandatory. Now we are trying to execute the file. We need sudo to execute it, but here we find illegal instruction. This is because the cross compiler I used generate binaries for Raspberry 4 and Raspberry 3, not for Raspberry 0. So back to my desktop, I will use wef command. Now I clean the command, the compile, and I configured the wef to use a specific cross compiler used for Raspberry 0. I will leave the link in the description. Now we I chose to generate the copter files only. I can generate any other vehicle and it should work. Okay, now the file is ready. We will copy it to Raspberry Zero using the same scp command. You can choose any other way. You can enable the FTP and copy it using FTP, but this is the simple way using command line. Okay, now the file is the file has been copied. Again, we enter to the board. This time, we will try to execute the ArduCopter. Here, I executed without sudo, and it will not work also. So I added sudo, and here it is. It is working. The idea now is that this Raspberry Zero is not connected to Opal board. It is just a Raspberry Zero, so it cannot find the sensors. But the result is that it is working. Now we also see a folder called ArduPilot has been created, and inside it there is the setting file in STG and there is the log folder inside the ArduPilot folder. Now we want ArduPilot to start every time I start the board. I want it auto run. The best way to do that in Linux on Raspberry is to use to create a service. It is a very simple process. You just create a file in a specific location, which is libsystemd system, and then your service name. This is a file. You need to define some parameters. Actually, it is these parameters are these parameters have a template you can follow. So you need to enter description. You need to enter some to define when to run to start your process, and if there is a contradiction with your process with if there is a contradiction between your process and another process, and what should the system do when there is a failure. It should restart or exit or whatever. As you can see here, there are many parameters including documentation, and the after parameter specifies the moment that you want the service to run your ArduPilot program. Here you define the conflicts. Now we are going to define the service itself. This is the most important line. This line describes the parameters that you will use to start ArduCopter. There are multiple parameters you can add. I chose to use serial 0 to broadcast on the Wi-Fi using UDP so that I can open my mission planner and listen to UDP packets directly from my board. As we see here, this is the way to define the UDP broadcast. You can add, for example, -C and attach it to port 1, serial port 1, to use the GPS, and -P to use the telemetry. And other parameters are also available and can be found in the documentation of this port. I will leave the link also in the description. Now the file has been written correctly. We need to enable it so that the system identifies it and add it to the startup list. Now the system included it to the startup list, and now we ordered the system to start the service. Now the system the service is up and running correctly. Thank you very much.